This video will explain how to analyze data from undrained triaxial test on clay, and I took this example from my book called Some Mechanics for Project-Based Learning. In this example we have a clay, and this clay has undrained friction angle of 29 degrees, and it has cohesion of 15 kilonewtons per square meters. So it's all effective stress conditions. So what we can write that shear stress for effective stress conditions is going to be normal stress times tangent of 29 degrees and plus cohesion, which is 15. So also we know that it was an undrained test. And before we conducted this undrained test, the sample was under all-around pressure. So this is the sample, and the pressure was all around. So it's another way to say confining pressure, or sigma 3. And in this case, it's 100 kilonewtons per square meters. And at some point, we changed to undrained conditions, and we applied diverter stress. And the diverter stress at failure was 170 kilonewtons per square meters. So what it says here, the difference in principal stresses, it's sigma 1 minus sigma 3, it's a diverter stress, and it's 170 kilonewtons per square meters. Okay, so that was at failure. And what we need to do is to find what was the pore pressure that was generated in the sample at the end of the test. So let's call it X, so, and this is what we're going to find. And first what we need to do is to draw a schematic diagram using more circle, and this is what I will do now. So if you look here on the right hand side, so this is the solution from the book, and I'm going to explain how we obtain all these numbers and how we obtain the value of pore pressure. So let's say that we are going to draw more circle for this test, and we know that sigma 3 is 100 kilonewtons per square meters. It's given here, and we need to find sigma 1, which is sigma 3 plus deviator stress, and it's going to be 100 plus 170, and that will be 270 kilonewton per square meters. So what we're going to do is, if this is one is normal stress and this one is shear stress, so we're going to find 100, let's say it's here, 100, this is 200, 300. So this is just a sketch, it's not to scale. So this is 270, sigma 1, 270, and we're going to draw a circle. Okay, so this is for undrained conditions. So now we're going to change to the effective stress conditions. Why we're going to do that is because we are given the shear strength of this clay under undrained or effective stress conditions. So that's the values that we're going to use, and that's very important. So what we're going to do is, to get to effective stress conditions, we're going to subtract water pressure. I'm going to write here U, and this is what we call X, because we're going to find it. And for the minor principal stress, again, it's going to be the same. Sigma 3 minus pore pressure, and this is the same pore pressure that we subtract. And you probably know that the deviator stress at failure is the same under total stress conditions and effective stress conditions, so it doesn't change, but it's still same number. So what I'm going to do, we're just going to move this circle to the left, and it should be about the same size. So what I did here, I use sigma 1 minus pore pressure, and this one will be sigma 3 minus pore pressure. So I just move it to the left. I didn't change the size of the circle, just move to the left to the effective stress conditions. And this is what we need, because we're also given the failure envelope for effective stress conditions. And we know this cohesion, it's 15. And we have a friction angle. So if we draw a failure envelope, it should go like this. So this is going to be phi friction angle, and it's 29 degrees. And this is going to be cohesion, which is 15 kilonewton per square meters. And what we also know, this failure envelope crosses this green circle at the right angle, so it's tangent to it. So if we get some point here, and we draw a perpendicular line like this. Okay, so this is again, this is a friction angle. And what we're gonna do now, we're going to write down all the stresses, and we will use this triangle. I'm going to write it in red. Sorry, putting it a bit. Yes. So this is the right angle, which just means 90 degrees. And we're going to find sine of this triangle. And what I'm going to write is, we're going to look at this sine. So if I call this one A, and this one is B, and this one is C, so sine of effective friction angle, it will be BC divided by AB. So now we're going to find BC, and I'm going to rewrite it here, sine of friction angle. So BC, it's the radius, this one of the circle. So which means that it's half of the circle, which means that it's going to be Q divided by 2, and that will be 85. So now we're going to look at this part, AC, and you know that AC, we can divide it into this part. So this part will be a cohesion divided by a tangent of friction angle. This is just from the geometry. So this part, it's the radius, which is Q divided by 2. And this part will be sigma 3 minus water pressure. So, and this is what we're going to write here. So I will be C cohesion divided by tangent of friction angle plus sigma 3 minus water pressure. So which is going to be 100 minus water pressure, let's call it X. And this part is the radius Q divided by 2. So this is how we get this equation. And this is a simple equation. We have only one unknown x, and if we solve it, we will find that x is equal to 37.3, and this is the pore to pressure, 37.3 kilonewton per square meters, that will be generated in the sample at the end of the test when the sample fails. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you know now more about Undrained Triaxial test. Bye.